Hello friends, your favorite sir, Pons sir is back here with the new tips and tricks will be his. So let's start with the topic is gas law. Gas law is one of the most simplest and scoring topic here. Mainly questions asked to be here is in terms of mains to be here is based on the ideal gas equation. And everyone knows what is my ideal gas equation. Ideal equation is nothing will be equal to PV equal to nRT here. PV equal to nRT here is. Now sometimes we will play with this equation here is pressure is given to you, volume is given to you, R is known, definitely known as temperature. They can ask you to find out the number of moles. So out of those four parameters, pressure, volume, number of moles and temperature. And if three parameters are given to you and they will ask you to find out the fourth. Simple. Sometimes they can modify this equation here is how will they modify? Number of moles can be written as to be weighed by molecular weight. Right? And if I write about weight by molecular weight and then take the volume on the right hand side, then weight by volume is known as density. So the only question can be based on here is PM is equal to DRT. So one of the JEE Main question is based on PM for DRT. P is the pressure, M is the molecular weight, D is the density, R is the universal gas constant, T is the temperature. Now if I can change the pressure, density get changed, temperature get changed here, so I can say P1 by D1 is nothing is equal to P2 by D2, T2. Then questions can be asked on the here is my average kinetic energy in here. Now I will find average kinetic energy is nothing is given here by 3 by 2 nRT. Where T is the temperature in terms of Kelvin scale. So what you find here is my average kinetic energy is mainly depending on my temperature, that is temperature in terms of Kelvin scale. So if you change the temperature, average kinetic energy gets change. Then informative based question, kinetic theory gases, that is the same thing we have also learned in terms of physics to be here. So need to be what are different postulates or assumptions of my kinetic theory of gases. Further questions can be here is based on here is Gram's law for diffusion, where I can say this rate of diffusion is depends on the pressure difference between the internal and outside, plus it depends on my molecular weight. How it depends on this? So I can say its rate of diffusion can be here is k times p here is that when there is current of molecular weight. Now sometimes we can correlate relatively what we is rate, how we can correlate relatively rate here is in that case I can say in that case rate of some known gas will be here is, let's say rate of one gas that the rate of diffusion of some other gas that is equal to here is pressure difference P1 by here P2 into molecular weight is added to the I can easily get correlate rate in terms of molecular weight and pressure. Then question can be based on this van der Waals gas equation that can commonly also known as the equation of my real gas. Everyone knows what is my equation of real gas or van der Waals equation, that is can called here is P plus An square by V square into V minus Np is equal to nRT. Where A and V are known as van der Waals gas constant. Kya bolenge A aur V ko? Van der Waals gas constant. Then what is significance of A? A indicate basically a force of attraction. And whereas V is indicate the size of the gas molecule. V can indicate karega. V is indicating the size of the gas molecule. Now sometimes V can be correlated with the radius of atom. So V is nothing is 4 into 4 by 3 pi r cube times Lagrange. V is equal to 4 into 4 by 3 pi r cube into Lagrange. Then compressivity factor. Compressivity factor is nothing but it's the ratio of PV by nRT. Now this ratio gives me idea about whether the given gas is a real gas or it can be a ideal gas. Now if Z is equal to 1, that indicates the gas is my ideal gas. There is Z is not equal to 1, that implies to be a real gas. Capital gas, real gas. So we can have Z versus P graph can be here. This is Z equal to 1 here. For hydrogen and helium, you find is Z is always greater than 1. And for real gases, here initially is Z is less than 1 and then in that high pressure Z is more than 1.
So at high pressure, Z is more than 1. At low pressure, Z is lesser.
Then sometimes say, can be able to explain why at the low pressure, Z is less than 1. At a high pressure, Z is more than 1. Let's try to understand here is, why we saying is Z is more than, greater than 1 at high pressure. Now consider for 1 mole of a gas. Now if we have 1 mole of a gas in the case, then N should be equal to 1. So let's say this equation gets reduced to N key value 1 another. So who gets equation? Now take a case where you have a pressure is high. Pressure is high. So at high pressure we face, the value of P is more than here A by B square. So I can neglect the A by B square in terms of compressible P. So this equation becomes P into B minus P equal to RT. Now I can rearrange this can be as PV is equal to PV plus RT. Divide both the side by RT here is. So Z is nothing, is it's a ratio of PV by RT. That is 1 plus PV by RT. Z is equal to 1 plus P by RT. Yes, at high pressure, Z is more than 1. Now, observe the case when we have is Z is less than 1. Now, if your Z is less than 1 here is, that means volume is relatively high as compared to B, this term is getting neglected. So let equation here is at low pressure. Right? Now multiply by B and rearrange here is, so this becomes PB plus A by B is equal to RT. Divide both the side by RT here is, so in that side is nothing, is PB by RT 1 minus A by VRT. So what we find, Z is 1 minus A by VRT, yani ki Z ki value kya hai? Less than 1 at low pressure. Then communication he asked in terms of mains is based on the speed here is. We can have root mean square speed. That can call as square root of brt by m. You have most probable speed, that is 2rt by m. And we have average speed, what is not m? 8rt by m. So, बहुत बार क्वेश्चन आए कि CRMS is most probable likely formula based. And sometimes they ask me find out the ratio. यदि formula हमारे में तो ratio निकाल सकते हैं. अब ये कभी कोई पूछना है कि सबसे ज़्यादा velocity किसकी है? सबसे ज़्यादा मेरे पास RMS, फिर average और least है most probable. Then we know one more thing is real gases can be behave like ideal gas. Real gases can behave like ideal gas at low pressure and high pressure. इस statement बहुत बार आ चुका है. This will be almost, I think, maybe just 2015 maybe I thought, or JEE 2017 maybe. Now focus over here is on thermodynamics. In terms of thermodynamics, they are asking question based on is what is intensive property and what is excess. So this is simply definition based over here is, right? Then question based on the law of thermodynamics, we can have first law of thermodynamics, second law and third law of thermodynamics. First law mein basically they are asking here is relation between internal energy, heat and work property. What is my first law? Change the internal energy is equal to Q plus W. Plus question can be asking here is find out the work done in terms of reversible process and work done in terms of irreversible. So work done in terms of they are asking is reversible isothermal process. So in terms of work time, in terms of reversible isothermal process, nothing is integral of here is PdV for volume is V1 to V2. I can replace pressure in terms of RT by V here. Now integrate is from V1 to V2, so this becomes minus nRT
ln of E V2 by
the constant act of work done.
This is work done in terms of reversible isothermal process.
Then they will commonly ask you to find out the work done in terms of irreversible isothermal process. In terms of irreversible isothermal process, I can say work done V is irreversible, or maybe you can be isothermal process. तो सबसे पहले हमको कैसे समझना है कि वाई इरिवर्सिबल प्रोसेस के बारे में बात कर रहे हैं। एक तो वर्ड लिखा होगा कि इरिवर्सिबल प्रोसेस है, या फिर वर्ड होगा वर्क डन अगेंस्ट कांस्टेंट एक्सटर्नल प्रेशर। क्या वो वर्ड लिखा होगा?
वर्क डन अगेंस्ट कांस्टेंट एक्सटर्नल प्रेशर। ये वर्ड तुमको दिया होगा समझ में आ जाएगा कि वो इरिवर्सिबल के बारे में बात कर रहा है,
राइट? तो कैसे वर्क डन निकालेंगे इस केस में? तो इस केस में वर्क डन हम बोलेंगे कि दैट इज नथिंग इज वर्क डन इरिवर्सिबल प्रोसेस माइनस पी एक्सटर्नल इनटू वी2 माइनस वी2। नाउ वी2 कैन बी रिप्लेस यूज इन टर्म्स ऑफ टेंपरेचर एंड प्रेशर, एनआरटी2 बाय वी2 माइनस एनआरटी1 बाय वी2। ठीक है, अब इसी में बोलेंगे यार इरिवर्सिबल है बट आइसोथर्मल है, तो टेंपरेचर T1 T2 क्या हो जाएगा? सेम हो जाएगा, तो यू कैन टेक इट आउटसाइड ऑफ दिस। ठीक है, सो माइनस पी एक्स टू एन आर टी बाहर ले सकते हैं एंड इट बिकम 1 बाय पी टू माइनस एन। ठीक है, तो ये फॉर्मूला राइट क्लियर कर लो, हाउ डज वर्क डन इरिवर्सिबल प्रोसेस इज माइनस पी एक्स टू इनटू वी टू माइनस वी वन। देन क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन हियर इज relation between enthalpy change at constant pressure and change in internal energy features. Solution is delta is equal to delta ng or delta E plus delta ng RT. Now depending on the delta ng value of features, if delta ng is equal to 0, then delta S is equal to delta E. If delta ng is positive, in that case delta H is more than delta E here. If delta ng is negative, then delta E is more than the delta H. फर्दर कॉम्प्लिकेशन फाइंड आउट द एंथैल्पी फॉर गिवन रिएक्शन। कोई भी रिएक्शन दिया है तो उसके हम क्या बोलेंगे, एंथैल्पी जो चेंज होगा, समेशन ऑफ एंथैल्पी ऑफ प्रोडक्ट्स माइनस एंथैल्पी ऑफ द रिएक्टेंट। यदि बॉन्ड एनर्जी दिया हुआ है तो उसमें बोलेंगे समेशन ऑफ द बॉन्ड एनर्जी ऑफ रिएक्टेंट्स। ध्यान रखो यहाँ पे फ्रेंड्स, एंथैल्पी इन दैट केस समेशन ऑफ बॉन्ड एनर्जी ऑफ द रिएक्टेंट माइनस बॉन्ड एनर्जी ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट्स। ये इंपॉर्टेंट ध्यान रखना पड़ेगा। कभी कभी एंट्रोपी रिलेटेड क्वेश्चन भी आते हैं कि व्हाट इज एंट्रोपी चेंज इन द रिवर्सल आइसोथर्मल प्रोसेस। तो सेम नेट फॉर्म ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन आई कैन से इट्स नथिंग इज एनआरटी ln of v2 by v1 हियर। देन कॉमनली क्वेश्चंस हियर इज आस्क्ड इन द टर्म्स ऑफ मेन सीरीज, व्हाट इज माय हीट ऑफ फॉर्मेशन, अमाउंट ऑफ हीट एक्सचेंज वी हियर इज लिबरेटेड व्हेन यू हैव वन मोल ऑफ अ कंपाउंड इज फॉर्म फ्रॉम एलिमेंट्स प्रेजेंट इन द स्टैंडर्ड स्टेट। Then question based on the definition straightforward, what is the heat of combustion gas? Okay, compound that react with it here is excess amount of oxygen here, such that is completely converted into a CO2 here. Then graphically based question here is almost two times we have repeated here is the question repeated by. On the y-axis the given is ln of k diya hai, or on the x-axis the given is 1 by t. और पूछ रहा है कि कौन सा ग्राफ एंडो होगा और एक्स होगा, तो उस केस में मुझे एक इक्वेशन याद रखनी पड़ेगी मेरे पास, ln of k equilibrium। क्या इक्वेशन है? ln of k equilibrium is nothing is minus delta h naught by r into 1 by t plus delta h naught by r। ये इक्वेशन हमको याद रखनी। ठीक है, अब इस इक्वेशन में मुझे क्या मालूम चलेगा, इस इक्वेशन से मुझे मालूम चलेगा स्लोप की वैल्यू क्या है। स्लोप इज माइनस डेल्टा एच नॉट बाय r। क्या मालूम चलेगा? स्लोप मालूम चल जाएगा। अब स्लोप पॉजिटिव भी हो सकता है, नेगेटिव भी हो सकता है। यदि स्लोप पॉजिटिव है तो डेल्टा एच क्या होगा? नेगेटिव। ये ग्राफ में देखो स्लोप पॉजिटिव है, क्या है? स्लोप पॉजिटिव है, यानी डेल्टा एच क्या हो गया? नेगेटिव। डेल्टा एच नेगेटिव, उसको बोलेंगे एक्सोथर्मिक। क्या बोलेंगे? एक्सोथर्मिक। वेयर एज इफ यू हैव डेल्टा स्लोप इज नेगेटिव, स्लोप नेगेटिव है तो डेल्टा एच क्या हो जाएगा? पॉजिटिव। ये स्लोप नेगेटिव, डेल्टा एच पॉजिटिव, यानी क्या हो गया? एंडोथर्मिक हो गया। इट वेरिएशन इज एंडोथर्मिक। Then communication based on here is how the delta G get correlated with the reaction question. Delta G is nothing is equal to delta G naught plus 2.03 RT log of Q here. Now if reaction is at equilibrium, reaction is at equilibrium. So what is in this case? At equilibrium here is we are aware about one thing is at equilibrium we are aware about here is delta G is 0 with the equivalent formula and Q is equivalent to equilibrium constant. Q is equivalent to equilibrium constant. So 0 is equal to delta G naught plus 2.50 RT log of K. So कभी कभी questions आते हैं कि delta G naught निकालो and find. Okay? Delta G naught can find out which is and equilibrium constant is going to be. So this is the simplest equation I can put it. और ट्रिकी करना है तो इसको हम कोरेट कर सकते हैं एंथैल्पी के साथ एंड एंट्रोपी. सो डेल्टा जी नॉट इज नथिंग इन दैट केस डेल्टा एच नॉट माइनस सी. ठीक है. और कभी कभी तुमको ये इक्वेशन यदि याद नहीं होती है तो सिंपल कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, ये तुम रिलेशन मालूम है राइट. दिस रिलेशन नोट दस इसको एल के टर्म लिखो राइट एंड डेड बाई आर टी इसी इक्वेशन को आ जाएगी. For the lecture here is delta G का significance क्या है. Delta G is nothing is indicated in this maximum amount of work done. ये क्या indicate करेगा maximum amount of useful work done क्या होगा. अब delta G zero हमको मालूम है कि वो equilibrium पे होगा. Delta G negative होता है तो reaction क्या है spontaneous. reaction क्या होगा वो spontaneous होगा. That means reaction is feasible. और delta G यदि positive होता है तो उसको हम बोलते हैं मतलब non-spontaneous. क्या वो non-spontaneous? That means reaction is not feasible at a given conditions. Wait for more topics in this series. We'll continue with a few more lectures. Be here is like our Facebook page Vidyalankar classes and publication, and also subscribe in our YouTube channel.